Damn, Jiro, I didn't tell you to do that, but oh well. We'll do what works. Come on, all for one, you fuck-faced bastard. Yeah, I'ma finish the job. All my men messed your face up, but this time I'ma make sure you can't even have a tube to deep throat. Uh-huh, your ass in that corner, boy. Get back in that corner, Peter Schmidt. Oh no, what I tell you, I said get back in that corner, Pewter Schmidt. I forgot he could teleport you. All for one, use a bitch. Sergeant Afro boy, you couldn't be more niggified if you tried. Damn. The coonery is strong with this one. Come here. You really thought I was gonna let you do that bullshit again? Did you? You talking about a sacrifice, you scary mofo? Well, that's exactly. And just to add insult to injury, I'm finna do this right in your fucking face. Woo! Oh, well, things backfire. It happens. But can you keep that going before I kill you? That's the thing. No time has run out. K.O. She hit him with the hammer. No, you don't. And this time when we send you to jail, you're getting black man time. Where you going? Fuck you, Deku. I swear to God, fuck you. Fuck! This is the best way to deal with him.
Alrighty, I'm ready to advance you.
Yep. Damn. Got your ass, nigga. Get him, Cammy. Shit. Shit. He got me in it. He got me in it. Shit. And you gonna call out Rapper, I bet. Oh, good. It broke. It broke. Get up. Get up, Momo. You bitch ass motherfucker. Yeah, just so you can't call out that Deku support. Let's get it. Which pissed him off vitally, since he felt like he was entitled to fame and fortune. But that's okay. After his house, he started hearing. You got beat by a 15-year-old girl, all for one. How's it feel? You going to jail for not only trying to lure a minor, separate from all that is, but for being cuckold as well, nigga. Try to cuckle the minor, you fucker. Yep, now going to jail now. Feels entitled to every gosh darn thing in the world. To increase his probability of, you know, not dying, Red forges himself a murder axe in a scene reminiscent of the opening scene in Conan the Barbarian, a movie with a lot of similarities to Mandy. This glorious gleaming battle Come on, because as soon as you stop. Yeah, that's what I thought. Shit, he combo after that. No. Come on, use a quirk now, Mirio. Oh, you try, Cammy. That's all that matters. Oh, I tried to counter him. Ooh, I'm out of meter. I wasted it, really. I should have saved it. Oh, well. I'm only going to have one shot at this. I got to hope it works. One shot at this. Pray that it works. Come on. Oh my god, he rage quit it. We still would have had another round to go. Well, at least I get the points. Fuck face. Ooh, nice.
Minnesota's gonna be a threat this year, dude. They're 3-1 right now. Wow.
Okay, put me down, Sokka. Got you.
Red drives his ATV through a tunnel, getting some serious bullet time while he does. Nice one, guy. And eventually finds himself on a cliff overlooking the rock quarry the Children of the New Dawn now call home. Yeah, why are they building that temple for Midsummer?
Oh.
Using some spiky road jacks, which is what I'll
That was nice. I don't know if that's going to kill me, though.
Drives down the road, then pulls Brother Swan out to beat him silly. Swan
Guess I'll find out. Nice. That was nice damage. It didn't kill me, though.
Eat it, bitch. Sister Lucy is left terrified, but perhaps remembering the roulette game she was forced to play earlier, Red leaves her and presses on.
Before you can call yours out, just stop it. This is how you level 2, Sokka?
He gets an axe to the head out of nowhere, and that's about it for him. Red then finds a chainsaw on the ground, a tool of his old trade. You know, before he became a professional.
Now that's plus ultra. Nice. Nice, nice combo.
Yes.
Should have called out my.
Shit.
His torso and face He's doing considerable damage to me. I probably could counterattack off of that next time. I need to remember that. Shit! Couldn't do nothing about that. Okay. Nice.
Easy.
Damn, I didn't mean to use Jiro like that. It bought me some time, though. Hurry, hurry, hurry!
Red grabs his head and kills him by squeezing it with all his strength. It's the kill that Red's been gunning for.
Are you kidding me?
Time, and it's gotta be a bittersweet feeling for the guy to finally achieve it. With his
really?
Work done, Red sets fire to the building and
stop
all the heads and bodies inside.
So, he keeps throwing interceptions every fucking game. The Midsummer
Temple, huh? Yes, I made her use our cami.
Red's ready to hit the road.
Yeah. Every fucking game he throws an interception.
He drives off in his car, imagining Mandy in the passenger seat next to him, even though the movie ends with a reminder that she's not really there, no matter how much hell he's gone through to avenge her. How many people wound up getting axed on Nick Cage's bloody path of vengeance? Let's find out.
Oh shit, I didn't know she could do that in the air.
First, let's have a little
dance. Damn, Jiro, I didn't tell you to do that, but oh well. We'll do what works. Plus Ultra! Oh, you got double team,
dude.
I just sacked. They intercepted me. I sacked them. I held them from getting a touchdown. I am shutting down. All right, Kareem.
Pick up that mask, Gran Torino, or beat it off.
Karen recounts her childhood of survival training and reenacting Silence of the Lambs to explain to her daughter why she doesn't want Lori around.
I've spent my entire life trying to get over the paranoia and neuroses that she has projected on me.
Maybe the monotone is supposed to stem from digging up childhood trauma. Still, seems kind of weird. Speaking of interesting vocal performances, here's this kid. His name is Kevin, and he is not excited about going on a hunting trip with his dad.
Wall splat, I think that's what he's trying to go for.
Yeah, also, he sounds like he just spent the first 15 years of his life screaming his lungs out. He and his dad come across the Spitzer of bus on the side of the road. The inmates wandering around, much like they did in that shot from the original.
And I just stack Mahomes again.
Kevin's dad gets out to see what's going on, while Kevin calls the police. But when his pops doesn't return, Kevin takes his hunting rifle and checks out things for himself. He finds a guard or a cop or someone on the side of the road, and for some reason, keeps his gun trained on him like the dude's an 8-bit dog trying to fly off screen. The guy isn't dead when Kevin finds him, but he seems to have bit the dust by the time we cut to a long shot. So I'm fine with having him kick off the cop. Our first kill, a full 30 minutes into the movie. Kevin approaches the bus looking for his dad, but instead, he just showcases more crappy firearm training. Then he flees from the scene of the crime? Damn, kid, who raised you? When he climbs back into his truck to get out of there, Michael stops him by rising from the back seat and grabbing him by the neck. You might expect this kid to...
See if
so
I call him.
I've held Mahomes to 33 yards.
Wow. And he kills Kevin by breaking his neck against the car window. Yeah, dude, they killed a kid. Although, to be fair, the series did do that already back in Season of the Witch. Since Kevin managed to call the cops before his untimely demise, Deputy Frank Hawkins shows up on the scene to reveal another couple of bodies to add to the count. We don't need to have this body in the background, because turns out that's Kevin. Just compare the clothes. It's clearly the same outfit. We can, however, add this cop who Hawkins notices on the side of the road. And before you even start, I don't think it's the same dude that Kevin found. Just compare where the two bodies are. They're on separate sides of the bus.
Definitely do that.
Different positions, and I don't think the cop Kevin found had enough collapse, his neck's so broken that it almost looks like there's some extra vertebrae in there.
Ouch.
When Hawkins checks the bus for any more bodies, he finds Dr. Sartain, who survived getting shot by Kevin, and who tells Hawkins that Michael Myers has escaped.
At ETI School of Skilled Trades, we teach skills that will always be in demand. Skills you can be proud of. The calloused hands, hard work type of skills. ETI gives you the certified practical training you need for a career in HVAC or skilled welding in just 7 months.
Oh good, you lost all your supports.
Quarterback's got a rough
touchdown. I still have yet to actually have Dak get one.
The next day, on Halloween, the podcasting duo heads to the Haddonfield Cemetery to look at Judith Myers' grave, where Aaron describes her death in such detail that it evokes flashbacks to the original. Here we have another great bit of commentary, this time on how some show...
Damn it, she was in the air.
And he just... I just got him to get one. He broke a sack and I just ran him into the end zone.
Who I beat him?
There was nobody anywhere near him when he took off.
In the face of the pole. Okay. Never fought Dobby with Momo. It's, oh, you just made your first mistake, soccer. Come here! Oh, wait, no. Oh, my God. I am sorry, Dobby. Look, things were said. I take back what I said. I really would do want to go to Casper Needles with you, Dobby. Dobby, please. Dobby, please. Get out of there. Oh, God, Dobby. Dobby, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, my guy. But we gotta beat your ass.
Okay, finally, decent
talent. Fuck you, Toga! Shit! Ooh, don't touch it, don't touch it. Good, now you don't got no supports. Come on, please catch him, please catch him, please catch him. No! Die, bitch. Oh, this is like fighting against Michael Myers. He's not dying. Dobby, please. Don't you take this round, nigga. You made your mistake! Got him! Oh my God, now we just gotta kill him. We just gotta kill him this round. We just gotta kill him this round. He don't got no meter though, so... Okay, Dobby, okay. We see you and raise you 350. Damn it, Toga. Shit. Did the other one. Shit. Ooh, I could have hurried up an armor. That would have been my saving grace. Damn, got you too, girl.
Yeah.
Come on, hit him. Yes! We got you, Dobby. It's over. If he survives this, I might just... Oh, shit. Rage quit. Oh, we got you, Bias. Okay, we did it. That was a tough fight. Damn, my arms are sore from all that moving. Shit. We literally moved the whole house yesterday. That was insane. Oh wow, Princess Ochako, time to kick your ass too. Did anybody tell you not to wear a white dress to a bar fight, bitch? Oh, she got Gang Orca and Rapper for support. See what them combos look like. Okay, they look beautiful. But thank you, game, for breaking it. Now let me show you what you're working with. Ow, you little two-bit hussy. Yo. Thank you, Cammy. Yes, okay, he got rid of Rapper. I ain't too worried about Gang Orca because he's just going to try to grab me. I don't know how you do that. I'll be surprised if you can find a way to make it work though, Dak. Bam! Hit you with my mallet, bitch! Get him! You slam Cammy! You never do that to Cammy. You respect that thickness. Plus Ultra, bitch. You gotta respect the thickness of a babe like that. You don't just slam her to the ground unless you got intentions of following up with that shit. You just slammed her to the ground to get rid of her ass. Hell no. When I slam a busty babe, it's because it's some shit about to go down. Ain't nothing wrong with that. And I hit you with the spear before I did it. Where's your curly mustache? Damn. That's why I called out just before. Oh, you lost Rapper again? You look distraught. Is everything okay? Y'all, you lost Gang Orca too. Are you sure you're okay, Princess Ochako? Oh no, nah, you finna learn your lesson for slamming my busty bitch. Come here. Oh, hands on deck, motherfucker. Get a Cammy. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, I'm over here. Hit in the back of the head with a pipe.